Hello friends, this is Neha Tulshan from Crescent Creation. Welcome to another video on my YouTube channel. Today's video is a part of Save the YouTuber Hop, which was put together in order to help the many crafters that are affected by the new YouTube rules that require a number of views and subscribers in order to earn money. Some of the biggest names in the crafty industries, along with some companies, have come together to help small channels like me and to bring you, the audience, some awesome new tutorials from artists you may have never seen before. So for this video, I'm using Pretty Pink Posh Friends Forever stamp set and creating a scene where four friends are holding each other's hands and the sentiment says, "I am so glad that we are friends." I felt that this was a perfect card for this hop. I'm really glad to have crafty friends who are there at the time of our need. So here I have masked all my images using full sticky post-it notes, and I am also masking off the bottom of the panel so I can create the sky. I'm using MFT mini cloud stencils and salty ocean distress oxide to create the sky. Also, after you are finished watching my video, click on the link in the description box below to check out the next person on the list. The more videos you watch and comment on, the better your chances are to win 1 over 120 prizes. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more crafty videos. And hit the like button to let me know that you like this video. So here, once I have created the clouds, I'm blending a little more of that salty ocean all over the top half of the panel to complete the look of the sky. Once done, I'll peel off the mask from the bottom to put it on the other side to ink up the bottom of the panel. Here I'm using peeled paint distress oxide to create the ground. Once done, we'll remove all the masks. This is how the panel looks after removing all the masks. Isn't it beautiful? I always love the reveal after removing a mask. Now the fun part, it's time to color the images. I had used Memento Tuxedo Black ink to stamp these images, and here I'm using Copic markers to color all these images. I'm not gonna share the complete coloring today because it's very simple and similar technique. And I have put the caps of the markers upright on the top left side for you to know what markers I'm using to color the particular image. And for the rest of the image that I'm coloring off camera, the markers are listed on my blog post. So don't forget to visit my blog for markers lists, picture link of the materials used, and more photos of the finished project. Here I was trying a new color combination to color this girl's hair. I wanted a little golden brown color hair, and I chose YR16, E35 and E18 as my color combo, and I was pretty happy with the result. Once finished coloring all the images, I brought in my cool gray markers to add shadows on the ground. I used C1, C3 and C00 here to add shadows. Now I'm stamping the sentiment at the bottom of the panel using Memento Tuxedo Black ink, and I'm using my Misty tool here to help me stamp perfectly. I've stuck the panel to a white side folding card base. Now I'm adding some details using my white gel pen. These small details help to add interest to your design. To finish off my card, I'm adding some sequins, some sparkling sequins from Simon Says Stamp. So this was my video for today. I hope you guys liked it. Don't forget to visit the next person in the list of the hop. The link is in the description box below. Don't forget to leave a comment below for chance to win a prize. Thank you for visiting. Have a nice day.